Good afternoon, and thank you for logging in to our second of our Lenten concert series concerts. Last week we had Christiane on cello with me on piano. This week we're getting Irish harp. My name is Barbary Grant, and it has been my pleasure to serve this lively congregation for the last 16 years as your organist. And the quotations are because if you come on any Sunday morning, in addition to the organ, I'll probably be singing, playing the piano, possibly the harp, or the cello, or the dulcimer, or some hand drums, or the shruti box. So those of you who have been attending Valley for any period of time have probably heard me play the harp, but you're hearing church harp. Church harp is Celtic folk, sacred, and classical music. During the week, however, I have a different job. I'm a hospital musician at El Camino Hospitals in both Mountain View and Los Gatos, and with wheels strapped to the bottom of this very harp, I simply roll around and play for everyone, patients, staff, visitors, and I play very different repertoire there. So with that said, get ready for some popular harp. And I'm going to start off with a piece by Sting. I hope you enjoy it. Thank you. That piece was Fields of Gold, written in 1992 by Sting and arranged for me as a birthday present by my friend Verlene Schirmer. I've gotten so much mileage out of that arrangement. This harp really requires special treatment. Arranging for an Irish harp is a really big deal. The music on the page looks just like the piano, But unlike a piano, I don't have the black keys. This would be like a piano of white keys only, which would be very limiting. So what I want to do, if I need a black key, is to flip a lever. So this is my middle C. It's red. That's how I know it's a C. I can play it. And if I flip the lever, it becomes a C sharp. Well, making those adjustments on the fly while I'm playing is quite a trick. And you'll see a lot of that going on because I was bound and determined to play some Gershwin. So this is one of his more famous pieces, Someone to Watch Over Me, 1926, arranged by the amazing Ray Poole, who I'll say a little bit about more later. But right now, Someone to Watch Over Me. Thank you. We might expect a lot of lever changes in something as jazzy as Gershwin's harmony. But what you might not realize is that the Beatles take the exact same number of lever changes. So here's a little something. Chris Primesberger, if you're tuned in, this one's for you. He's our resident Beatlemaniac. Thank you. When I first started playing in hospitals, they got church harp because that's what I knew how to play. But then I started working here at Valley, and we do a lot of weddings here at Valley, and it's brides who keep me current. They have their favorite songs and they want those songs played at the wedding. So I started to pick up some popular tunes and brought them into the hospital where they were so very well received and brought such comfort and started so many conversations that I just keep bringing in more and more and more. This is one of those tunes. For a long time, I fought all things Disney in church, but the brides overcame me. This one was brought to us by Scott Russell's lovely bride, Erin. Scott is Karen Russell's son, and he was married here. And she brought in all sorts of tunes, including this one from the movie Up, which I hope you'll really enjoy.
Thank you.
So all these lever changes you're seeing me do, you don't see in an orchestra harp. They do that with feet pedals. There are 7 of them on the back of the instrument that you usually don't see, and they artificially lengthen and shorten the strings rather than having to let go of a string and reach up and change a lever. So they can play a lot more complicated chromatic music. One thing that all harps have in common, however, is that they go out of tune very easily. They're made completely of wood and so change with any difference in temperature or humidity. And that's happened to me. So give me, actually, I believe the saying is that harpers and harpists spend 90% of their time tuning and 10% of the time playing out of tune. Give me just a moment. This next arrangement is still very much a work in progress, but I really wanted to put it in the program today because my mother's here, and this is one of her favorite songs. This is from 1955, Unchained Melody. It was actually written for a very little-known prison movie called Unchained, and somehow this amazing song came out of that and has outlived the movie by a stretch. For me, it always conjures the day when I was a youngster and my dad took my brother Eric and I to Kmart with a few long cherished birthday dollars clenched in our fists, and we each bought our first LPs. And I got Bridge Over Troubled Water by Simon and Garfunkel. And my brother Eric picked out The Righteous Brothers. And it was a black cover, and it had a big picture of their faces, and then the huge words, "Far Out." So for some reason, whenever I play this song, I get to think about both my mom and my brother. This is for you. And since a lot of you are churchgoers, pray during the bridge. There's a key change. I have to change 4 levers and turn a page at once. Thank you. next tune is one of my very favorites to play. I really love music from the 30s. So many wonderful things were written. This one in particular by the duo of Lawrence Hart and Richard Rodgers, who wrote so many wonderful songs. Again, it's got jazz chords, so I'll be doing a lot of lever changes. And I'll also be playing a little bit, play de la table, which means close to the soundboard. It just gives it a different tone. And a few harmonics, and it's all full of special effects. But I just can't get past the words. Your looks are laughable, unphotographable, but yet you're my favorite work of art. This is my funny Valentine. I'm often asked, what's my favorite song to play? And I can't answer that because it changes every 3 days when I find a new song that I add to my notebook. Right now, this next tune is my favorite tune to play. And it is so well loved and just transforms whatever space it's in. This is Landslide by Stevie Nicks, written in 1975 and recorded by Fleetwood Mac. Written about her relationship with Lindsey Buckingham and her relationship with her dad. There's something really potent about this song and sort of surprising that it fits on the harp so beautifully.
One of the places I'm getting a lot of bang for my buck with this tune are in the behavioral health units in the hospitals where I play. This music is the language of the spirit, and it's just a really potent place to play it. And I get all my best patient quotes from those units. And my favorite one is a lady I was playing for said, "Oh my gosh, the vibrations from these strings are shaking the crud off my soul." I just love that. So carry that with you as you enjoy Fleetwood Mac here. Before I launch into my last tune, I want to thank you so much for tuning in, and we'll remind you that there are more opportunities to watch some live stream music from this sacred space. Next week at the same time, we'll be featuring Angela Schillace on violin, kind of breaking away from the hospital set you got today to more classical repertoire, some beautiful tunes in there.
And then the week after that, we're featuring Guy Franca, who is our young Brazilian guitarist friend, a friend of Jenny's, who's provided some just gorgeous, gorgeous music for worship. And he'll be then. And then on the 21st, I will be playing an organ concert. So hopefully after a year of being out of the sanctuary, I'll figure out how those pedals work. So tune in for that. And then our last one on the 28th will be the Beyoncé Mass, and that should be really exciting. Thanks again for tuning in. I'm going to end this set just with something fun that I can't believe works on the harp. But this is A Brown Eyed Girl by Van Morrison. Thanks again, and thanks to Rolf and Joe, who are running around here with cameras and microphones and wires and making this all happen. Hope to see you again next week. Thank you.